Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. How are you all doing? Thank you so much guys for your love and support. Thank you for your lovely comments and all the other comment that is not that lovely. Thank you so much guys. I really appreciate each and every one of you. Thank you so much. So in today's video, there's something I want to share with you guys. Have you guys seen by the title? I just feel like I need somebody to talk to, and you guys are the best person I can share my, you know, and my feelings with, because at the moment, you guys know, we have lockdown, everything is closed. I don't even have a friend. You guys, you know me, you guys are my friend, you're my personal person. It's just like, you know, it's long distance friendship we have, right? So I want to start saying that before you guys send me comments or before you guys judge me or anything, please watch this video to the end before you drop your comment, because sometimes I feel like it's not fair when you guys will not, you just click on the video and you just hear one or two words and then you now start typing. So please watch the video to the end to be able to understand where I'm coming from and where I'm going. Okay guys, so as you guys see by the title, I'm planning of resigning from my job. To tell you guys, those of you that you are new to my channel, that you are welcome. And if you guys wondering what kind of job do I do, I'm a healthcare assistant, short for carers. Okay, so I started working in my work since 2018, and to tell you guys, it's one of the best job I've ever got, especially with the people I work with. We work as a team, you know, so I just love it. You know, it's not like I have problem at work, that's why I'm saying I want to resign from my job. But there are some things that, you know, when it happens to you, just think that, is it necessarily, does it really worth it? You know, you have to think. And sometimes only you thinking alone is not good enough. You have to share your problem. As I always say, share your problem with people so they can help you. That's why I'm sharing it, that one or two of you might be able to advise me what to do, you know, encourage me. I know some of you here will send me negative comment, but please, those of you that you like sending me negative comment, please guys, in this video, do not send me negative comment. Just be kind once to me, once. If you have not been kind before, let this video be the first one you be kind to. Don't send comments, or you just feel like, the way this girl is talk, Tamilara, my body is aching, I need to send this comment to her, I need to hit her. Please do not. I understand it's not that easy. Sometimes you want to let it out. Please don't. What I would advise you to just do, just give me thumbs down. Okay, that's okay. But I'm going through something already that I'm not getting myself. So it's not fair if you guys come here and leave me nasty comment. And those of you that you always leave me good comment, God will reward you. I tell you guys, God will reward you. And those of you that you leave nasty comment, sometimes I know it's not your fault. You just feel like, let me do it for fun. Not knowing that the person you are throwing that kind of comment at, they are human being just like you. So you guys, please guys, and God will reward you guys as well. Whatever you do, if you do bad, God is there. If you do good, God is there. So you choose what you want to do. Okay, anyway, so as I'm doing this video, when I check my subscriber, I have 124,850. So I'm sure maybe by tomorrow or in 2 days time, I'll reach 125,000 subscribers. Thank you so much guys for subscribing, you know. So let me go straight to the point. So I want to resign from my job because there's so many things going on that I'm like, at my age, you know, I turned 40 last year December. I'm like, All my life, I've been, there's like people doing like this, controlling me. So I'm like, now, I'm not a child anymore. I'm an adult. I'm 40. You guys might be seeing this baby face. I was born in 1980. I'm like, I'm not a baby anymore. I can't afford anybody to be doing like this to me anymore. I had enough since age of 9. those of you that I don't know half of my story, age of 9, I've been doing maid till what age? That would be story for another day. I'm not those kind of girl that I kind of experience life, how to do like this, how to do like, I never. Along the time I got freedom, like, I'm like, oh, now I'm free. Let me explore the world. Let me now see what I want to do for my life. Apart from being made all my life, that is when my husband came in. And when my husband came in, 2 years later, we didn't waste time. We just start having our babies, you know. So I thank God for everything I had today. I thank God. Like, it can't be better. It can't be better, guys. But at one stage of your life, there's something that will be going on around you that you'd be like, why is this going on? Am I making the right decision or am I making the wrong decision? So what's going on now? Last year, those of you that you are new, you might not know the story. Last year August, my mom turned 60 and I wanted to go home. I was planning to go home 2 years ago, but I don't know what happened. I couldn't go home. So I now said, okay, last year, which I now say 2 years ago, next year, which was last year, I said, well, my mom will be turning 60 and that would be a good time for me to go home, and then we are going to throw a surprise party. I was in this country planning the surprise party among my siblings. It was my idea, me and my oldest brother ideas were, but I'm more involved in the party planning. So I'm like, okay. And then, and you guys know, during August, ticket is always expensive. So when I look for tickets, I have an agent who I normally pay money to that always book my tickets and all that. When the time I was going, the ticket was around almost £1,600, if I'm not mistaken. So I pay, it's not like I pay once. I can't afford to pay once. I pay maybe like 5 times, you know, but I think they'll give you 3 months to the time you travel, you have to finish paying off. So is it 3 months or 2 months to the time you travel, you have to finish? So I finished paying it off. So I was hoping for the time to come. I've taken annually from work. Immediately annually form came out. January or before the time the annual leave came out, I was the first person that put my annual leave because I didn't want to miss it, you know, because it happened to me that so I put all that, and then this whole virus came along and I couldn't travel. All the plan, nothing happened. When I was trying to go, there's no plane working. The international airports were closed. I couldn't go. The agent told me that I was so worried. I'm like, okay, what's going on? The agent now told me that, oh, I should not worry. My ticket valid for 2 years. So anytime I have like open ticket. So at least I was happy that, oh, that's good. Anytime I want to travel, I don't have to buy another ticket. Although after that, I want to go home. After that, I end up paying for another ticket. I don't know how many of you know. I don't want the story to be so long, but I lost my grandmother during that period that I'm supposed to go home that I couldn't. So I find one another ticket online with another agent that I have to pay 740 something pound. So, but I couldn't go and they refund me. But that my agent have been using for years. My £1,600 plus was still with him. So anyway, I'm like, okay, since I can't go home anymore, because anytime I want to travel, I always make sure that I travel during the time the kids are not going to school. I want to make sure my kid is at home, because I can't travel when my kid is going to school. I always put my traveling time. That's why my ticket is always expensive. So I now say, okay, maybe this year I'll go around April. So that's what I have in mind. Okay, so I don't mind. I'm just, so when I now book my annual leave, I book it that, okay, I run around March to April. They said it's not available. Someone have taken it already. I said, okay, fair enough. Before that, I just think about it that, oh, now that there's lockdown, these kids are not going to school. They're actually home. This is the best time for me to go home. At least since that, the reason why I normally go home during those times that ticket is expensive is because they are still going to school. Now that they are home and it's not like there's no flight. Flight is working. This is the best time for me to travel. So I called the agent. I asked the agent that, okay, I have... So before I called the agent, I told my daughter to go online to find me tickets. We find some so cheap ticket, like 490, 500. So I'm like, oh, that is good. So the next day I called the agent that, what is going on? You have my 1,600, almost 600 with you, and you're not even saying anything. What is going on? He was like, oh, he's sorry, blah, blah, blah. I said, okay, I need my refund. He said he can't give me a refund. That they can only give me voucher. I remember last year he told me that the tickets, the money I have with them valued for 2 years. Anytime they can give me ticket. So I said, okay, let's say I want to travel today and I want ticket, and the ticket is for £500. And you have times three of the money. What's going to happen? He said, we just issue the ticket. How much they are selling the ticket, and the remaining money that is with us. Next time we want to travel, we just have to issue you another ticket. But we don't give back cash. We can only give you voucher. And I'm like, oh, okay. So, and he said the money now is now 1.5 years. Because they give me 2 years. 6 months don't pass. Okay. My work, when I put my annual leave form, my manager didn't tell me that I cannot take it. I was hoping that I can take it. So I now think that, because they are saying that between 5th of March or 8th of March, school resumes. So I'm now thinking that, why the kids still at home? Let me just quickly go before that time. So I went to, I now take another annual leave form and now change the date. And I call my manager just to confirm. I've not issued my ticket, just to confirm. I call my manager. I told my manager, oh, did you see the form I put in? I don't want that March. Instead of March, I want to take February to March, instead of March to April. So my manager was like, no, I can't take February to March because somebody have already taken it already. I said, okay, let me stick to my original annual leave. My manager was like, did I bring any form earlier? The cancel, blah, 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 blah. So she checked, she said, I can't still go because somebody have taken. Now, the reason why they are saying I cannot go on holiday because of someone I've taken, you guys, you know, those of you that you know, I only do 2 days a week. I do Wednesday and Thursdays. And on my job I do, we have on call. Any of you that you do the kind of related job, or maybe your job they do it, they have on call. Those of you that you don't know on call. On call mean there'll be a particular day that if anybody cancel, that day you have to be available to come to work. And that day is Saturday. So my colleague that took the annual leave, she is to work on Saturday. So they were like, oh, because of three shifts Saturday, they are saying I can't go on holiday because I have to be available to do on call. Why my colleague that normally work on Saturday she's on a holiday for 3 weeks. So I was just a bit down, and the last time I saw my mom was going to 5 years. It was going to 5 years. And I can see it in my mom's eye. She really missed me. She wants to see me with all the thing going on. Anytime they send me picture, I'm talking to her. You know, she just want me to come and see her. That is all she asked. But I can't. Now, those days that the time I want to go home, I couldn't go, is because, oh, before you start planning for money for ticket, before you start planning for the driver that's going to drive you, before you start planning for this, before you start planning for that. But at the moment, if I said I'm going home tomorrow now, I don't have to buy ticket. I have my ticket already. I'll just call my agent to issue me ticket as long as the flight is working. And because of those three shifts, they are telling me I cannot go because someone have taken. I have to be around. So what is really hurting me now, that it's not like my own shift, my Wednesday and Thursday. It's not like someone, if I go on holiday, someone that will do on call every Wednesday will be around to do my every Wednesday shift, because that will be on call. Somebody will be also available to do a Thursday on call, which is, they are all available. They didn't go on holiday, but because of that, just three Saturday, I cannot go and see my mom at the right time. Why my kid is on holiday now? Why ticket is cheap now? God knows the way the whole thing is. I have positive mind, but the way the whole thing is going out, nobody can even plan anything anymore. Because you plan this, I want to do this tomorrow. By the time tomorrow comes, the plan is changed. they just change the plan for you, society or whatever. So I'm like, now you, God knows, by April now, you don't know, maybe they will say, oh, plane cannot even go and nobody can go anywhere, everybody should stay in their house. So this now I have opportunity. I've not seen my mom now for 5 years. You guys think, imagine that. It's not be say I don't get paper, not be say I don't get money for tickets because of just 3 days. I mean, three shifts, one Saturday, the other Saturday, because I only do 2 days, and that Saturday is on my own call. I can't go. So when I think about it, I'm like, time is going. What I mean, time is going. I have 1 year, 6 months for my ticket to expire. So if I go now, maybe by around December, I can go by next year before the ticket expires. So am I just going to allow my 1,600? I think it's around 1,000. I don't think it's up to 600, but we need just a little change for it to be 1,600. Am I just going to allow that money to just go like that? Or I should just resign and say, okay, bye-bye, take your job. Or I should just go and make up story. You know, I don't know how to make up stories. I should make up story that, hey, I have emergency, I need to go. I don't know how to do that, because God forbid, if emergency now happen, what am I going to tell them? When I've already lied, when emergency is not going, I'm not those kind of people that because you want to go on holiday, you have to be saying all these negative things. No. So I said, let me come here to tell you guys that this is my problem. What do you guys think I should do? Should I resign? But I'm thinking that if I resign now, I do shakara and resign and go and see my mom. Because I'm not going home because of family or because I want to see Africa. I'm only going to see my mom. I need to go and visit my mom. I need to see her. So I'm here to ask for advice. Is there any advice you guys can give me? Do you guys think I should not go home? I should just, you know. And you know the sad thing? My passport, my Nigerian passport is going to expire in August. So even though I say, okay, August is the time I will travel because the kids have like 6 weeks. My passport is expiring in August. And you guys know what is going on now. Everything is locked down. I don't even know what to do. I don't know. That's why I'm here. And I'm like, if I resign my job now, where will I start from? Although it's only 2 days, but those 2 days I'm doing, the money is helping. So I'm like, you know, I have 100,000 plus. If you guys donate £1 to me, I'll be 100,000 richer. Then I don't have to go to work. You know, anyway, that's just a joke. But one thing I'm also here to tell you guys, that for me to have 124,000, that means you guys love the video you see on this platform. That's why you click on the subscribe. So why, if I upload video, you guys, you don't watch it? I mean, why? Let's say the video I'm uploading, I'm even getting view like 60,000, 70,000 each time I upload video, even twice a week, I'm getting that kind of view. I can only upload even 2 videos a week because sometimes I don't even get strength to do video. You know, I won't have to be thinking of this 2 days job. That's why I say, when you guys, maybe there's something I'm doing that you guys don't like, that's why you don't watch the video. That's why I said, I've said, and I'm tired of saying, that's why I didn't even say it anymore. I said, if there's any particular video you guys subscribe to, you like, please let me know that I subscribe to this video, I like it, I'd like to see more. So I'll see how many people subscribe to that video. I'm sure there should be a place on video manager that I can check. You know, I want to see what you guys, and if this is your first time coming across this channel, see my face, and you want to stay and you subscribe, please leave me a comment, let me know that you subscribe to this video. And those of you that you are going to watch this video, let me know the particular video you subscribe to and what you like to see. Okay, please guys. So I want you guys' opinion. What should I do? Should I just tell my manager I need to go? Please bear me, I need to go and see my mom, I've not seen her, please help me. And I've also contact a colleague who can help me, you know, when I'm not around, maybe she can help me with the on call. I've not heard from her, so this is my problem. And the reason why I'm here, like, I want to resign, that what I said earlier, that I keep going like this, like, because I'm doing 2 days job now, I can't do what I want. Yes, so I'm stuck because I'm doing just 2 days in a week shift. I'm stuck, I can't do anything. I can't. Like, I remember those days when I was home. I resigned my job, I was home. Anytime we are going on holiday, I don't need permission from anybody. We just book, we go. But now, because I'm doing only 2 days, not 4 days, not 5 days, only 2 days shift are they do now. They are saying I cannot go. Is it fair? So at my age, yes, guys, I know some of you that what does that have to do with your age? It has to do with a lot. There are something that are happening in our life that we have to open our eyes and see that. Why is it happening? Like, why? At my age, because of 2 days. That's why I don't want wahala. It's not like that 2 days job I'm doing. The money is so okay for me. I'm so comfortable. I don't need more. I wish I'm doing 5 days a week, because the more you work, the more money you make. But I don't have the strength. I don't want the situation that I want to go somewhere. I won't be able to have time for my family, my kids, which that have happened to me past. I was working, working, working. My job is my first home. Yes, I work 7 days a week those days. But these days I'm like, no, 2 days is enough for me. And now, because I'm trying to avoid this kind of thing, that's why I said I want 2 days, just 2 days. So the 3 weeks I'll be going for, that is only just six shifts. So, and I can't, because I'm doing somebody's job, I cannot do what I want. That's why I'm saying, you guys, please help me. Watch my video. And if you guys think my video is boring, why did you guys subscribe? I have 100 plus. Let me know the kind of video you want to be seeing, so that when I upload, you guys will be able to watch. At least, even though if it's 20,000, 30,000 of you watch the video, I'll be really, really happy. Please, guys. That's why I'm just here to talk to you guys, like, what is going on, please. Because it's just like, why do I have so many subscribers and then you guys are not seeing my video? So let's say you guys are really watching my videos. I'll just do shakara. You guys take your job, Jerry. Who even want your job? I know people that this YouTube is their full-time job, because they are making it. Like, I'm just thinking, like, what is that? You guys just advise me. Is there something I'm doing that you guys don't like? Because I don't understand why you guys use your decision to stay. It's your decision to subscribe because you like what you see, you want to see more. And then I upload video you will not see. And I've got a lot of bully on this platform. Yes, guys, there are just some things that I can't be bothered, because it's because of what I'm saying that brought out the topic. Some people send me comment that, hey, your subscriber is suspicious. How come you have so many subscribers and you struggle to reach 1,000 views? It's true. Why? It's just like, I'm somebody that I don't like, I cannot give up. And I always say, even though I'm one person, even this video I'm saying now, I'm doing, even I'm one person watch, it's okay by me. Do you guys understand? It's okay. People are bullying me for my subscriber. Why do you have so much and your view is so low? It's not my fault. You guys saw my channel you subscribe to. It's not, I didn't force anybody to subscribe to. Why did you guys stay? If you know you don't want to watch the video or you don't want to come back, why subscribe? Because I don't understand. So let's say you guys are the way you stay. I really appreciate you guys. It's not, I don't, I'm just saying the what is going on. Like I said, the way you guys like the video, you subscribe, you stay. Let's say you see my video, you watch. All this thing, I'm very unhappy, because if I don't go home now, I don't know when I'll be going home, and I believe everything happened for a reason. And sometimes it's not like things, it's just some people, they want to pull you back. They don't want to see your happiness, because I don't see the reason why, really, because of 3 shifts, I cannot go anywhere. I cannot go and see my own mother. Because I'm also thinking my kids are on their home now. This is best time for me to go home, because the way they are saying now, by March they are going back to school. When they go back to school, I need to be home doing school runs. So my kid to come home, tell me, what did you learn in school? What happened today? I need to know. My kids can't be going to school and I'll be in Africa saying I want to go and see my mama. Do you guys understand? But they are home now. I know they are safe. And this is what is happening. So I'm saying, if you guys, I have more support with you guys, I would have just said I'm going. If they want to take their job, they should take. But now I can't do shakara. That's why I need advice from you guys. What do you guys think I should do? Please, guys, help me. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for listening to my story. I really appreciate you guys. And yeah, I want to say more, but I can't. I'll see you guys in my next video. Love you all. Please leave me comments. Leave me comment down description below. Let me see your opinion and all that. I love you all. Bye.